What's up?
Brian, you know the song Red, Red Wine?
Yeah, that's from UB40. The old
Red, Red Wine.
Yeah.
It's a thing I drink in a bottle. It comes to me from Walgreens or 7-Eleven.
It comes in a box or in a bottle. It sounds, UB40 sounds suspiciously close to the Captain Morgan.
He does. How about this? How about you had to bust out that like red, red one. You make me feel so fine. You make me
say, I want to hear Captain Morgan if he was doing that solo. So it's like, I'll toss to you like red, red one.
Number one, don't even think that I didn't just try to do that to you and you just double flipped it and threw it right back in my face.
Well, as if it was my own idea. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
And also, I wanted you to embarrass yourself in improv.
Yeah, but only one of us is famous for doing the Captain Morgan character, and the other one just does a shabby interpretation of it. All right, so here. UB40 with a red wine. Wait. Red, red wine.
Red, red wine, you make me feel so fine. You keep me rocking all of the time. Red, red wine, your mother's, I'm from a boat. And then I go and rode a goat. I rode a goat to a sunny field. I rode a goat until it died. I killed a goat because it wasn't in good repair. I couldn't fix it with my underwear. Go!
Okay, hold on.
Red, red wine!
Come on, we got to do this. We got to do the whole track again. This is the track right here. We'll talk about UB40 and how they rehashed old shit, and then we'll do Cap Morgan.
No, I think we just need to roll right into the song.
Okay, all right. You want me to start a new track? All right, here we go. You remember the band UB40?
UB40, dog. I'm 32.
UBLA.
I actually, UB40 was like one of like the third albums that I ever bought.
What?
That UB40 album, yeah.
UB40 was like the fourth generation to do the way you do the things you do and make it a number one hit in their decade. It was like in the 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s.
Yeah.
And then they were
they were big. It was like fake. It was like reggae for whites. it was untapped resource.
I don't even know if they were white, or I thought they were like Scottish.
No. I'm not.
Shit.
I don't know if they were white. I know that whites loved them.
That's all that matters. Okay, but the part that I remember most is like that. You remember that song, Red, Red Wine?
Yeah, when I it do. Goes, yeah, no.
Yeah, and they would go all, they were red, red wine, and they would go all
red,
reggae.
Red wine.
Right, and they'd be like, red, red wine, you make me feel so fine. Like, yeah. Doesn't that sound like Captain Morgan? Red, red wine, you like, make me feel so fine.
In reality or yeah. In our heads?
I mean, our version of Captain Morgan.
Yes, no, as opposed to
is that the historical? Yes, he's like red, red wine to make it. I'll fuck a goat, or it's like I don't know. I want to indulge me here. All right,
you want
to
do the
I'll toss to the bridge.
The
right?
Breakdown.
Yeah, here we go. Here
Captain
we go.
Morgan. Just, this is like the liquor closet fucked and made music.
That's fine. Just take it. I'm gonna sing off key, and then you're gonna take it, and you're gonna freestyle into spaces we've never seen before as Captain Morgan. All right, red, red wine.
Red, red wine, you make me feel so fine. I'm a captain all of the time. I drive a boat and I sail the seven seas. I saw a mermaid, then I took a pee. I took a pee in the ocean blue. It's blue because I took the four poos. My poo's blue because I ate a disc that I found in a urinal after taking a piss. I said piss twice, it's because I have to pee. It's just the funny fact about me. I'm a captain and I'm famous for sailing, and your mom's a whore and she's famous for sucking. That didn't rhyme, but it doesn't matter because I'm made of antimatter. I'm antimatter and that's scientifically impossible, but I'm the captain and you're a dog. Stop recording me, dog. You're get out of here. Get away my BB gun.
It's a platinum album, guaranteed. I gotta press stop. I can't find the cursor. You remember the band UB40?
They're the one who did Red, Red Wine, right?
Yeah, among their other hits that were retreads from the 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s.
But their biggest, I mean.
Yes, no, red, red wine.
But like, yeah, why was it so goddamn, like, was it like red wine fever sweeping America? Like, was it?
You know what I think about? I think it was that reggae freestyle in the middle. Because they would do the red, red wine, and then they'd cut to like some token black person.
Right. This was before there was a rap interlude in literally every song.
Including Friday. Yeah, no, before Friday made it a cliche, it used to be a hard edge. But if you listen like the red, red wine make you feel so far. Like when I start to sing it, I turn into Captain Morgan.
Oh, so you don't think like, you know, it's some duddy rock Jamaican reggae.
No, I think it's actually they got our captain.
This sounds like Captain Morgan.
Maybe the captain. I'm gonna sing off key and you're gonna take it. Ready? Red, red wine.
Red, red wine, you make me feel so fine. I'm the captain and I like time. I keep a watch up on my wrist and I look at it when I take a piss. I take a piss off my boat. If you don't like it, you can smoke some rope. Smoke all the rope in a big fat pipe. If you don't like it, then you're a tyke. I didn't say the other word that Brian said 2 weeks ago because I'm not offensive and it's weird for me to say it. It's odd to bring it up in a freestyle rap, but that just means that I'm a piece of crap. I'm wanted in 40 states for doing crazy shit like slapping apes. I slapped an ape when I was in the zoo, and I'll do it to you too. I one time was friends with one ape. He was like, I think all those apes had it coming when you slapped him in the face. His name's Ed. We still keep in touch. We email each other every other month.
Red, red wine. Captain feels so fine. All right, bro. So it's the mid-90s. You and I are dancing at our prom. And what starts playing? UB40.
Oh, crap. UB40. Reggae for whites.
Well, I mean, I don't know if they were white or were. I thought they were like Scottish or some crap.
But the legendary place where non-whites gather.
I heard there's black Scottish. All right, let's start it again. All right. So it's we're in Cozumel, Mexico, mm-hmm. and it's spring break. We're in college. It's 1992, 1993. Right. You and I are grinding on each other's crotches because we're trying to hit on each other.
All right.
All right. So it's junior senior prom.
Okay.
Mid-90s.
Yeah.
We're at the dance. And what starts playing? UB40.
UB40, the mortal nemesis to Ace of Base.
they're actually, UB40 was like, Ace of Base needed to be born out of their music vagina and get stabbed in the back by Ace of Base, and then both of them would die in history together.
Exactly. From the blade that was formed together by the group that did Bad Boys, What You Gonna Do? Inner Circle.
Do you ever remember the 90s?
Yeah, I remember the crap out of it. That's my decade that I do remember all of.
I'm like, that's the decade before I started drinking. So I have vague memories of things I hated, and one of those things was UB40.
Oh man, that was a jam.
It was
that
very was a popular.
Jam that, you know, everybody loved it. Mom loved it. Other white people loved it. Like, it was just a jam for everybody that was white.
UB40 was like robbing the graves of people in the 60s and like just saying it with like a groovy beat in the 90s, and everyone loved it. But like, I heard the other day the Red Red Wine song, you know, Red Red Wine, right? Mm-hmm. And when it got to like the reggae stuff, as the guy started with like Red Red Wine, you can feel so fine. There was something about like the vague slur that made me think of Captain Morgan.
I thought you were going to go there. It was the captain to your ears.
It was like if the captain had a time machine, he would go back to the 1990s and he would get hired by UB40 to do the white man.
I was on the original track, Brian. I was on it. I said to him, UB40. You be paying me 40 ducats for this sweet track I'm dropping.
Can we play through what it would be like if he was
the original track, Brian? Lead me into it.
All right, listen, Captain. I'm gonna give you the off key intro. I'm gonna point at you. Sure. You just take it. All right, freestyle, whatever comes to mind. Right, Red, red wine.
Red, red wine, you make me feel so fine. You keep me laughing at a lime. I keep limes in my belt pocket because I hate scurvy and that and a jacket. You're a dick and I'm a pussy. You better fuck me or you're a big fat wussy. I drink 45 bottles of rum because I want to show you I can keep them in my tum. I keep them in my tummy and I roll around and I roll on a carpet that's on the ground. I giggle to myself, then I put on clothes because I was naked before, don't you know? That was evocative rhymes I was saying. If you painted a picture in your head for days. My name's Captain Morgan and I'm here to say that I'm a fat ass dick in a major way.
Red, red wine. All right, quick. Name bands from the 90s. Go.
George Herbert Walker Bush.
Keep going.
UB40.
Oh, shit. You've got right there. All right. Hold on. Let me hit. Quick. 1990s. Name a band.
Alice in Chains.
Yes. And...
White Zombie.
And more
Norman
popular.
Norman Schwarzkopf.
Keep going.
Ace of Base.
Keep going.
I don't
You're
know.
You're missing UB40, sir.
Fuck.
Yeah, because grave robbing the songs from the 60s to make them popular to white frat boys in the 90s was their jam, right?
And moms. My mom loved the shit out of UB40.
Wait, your mom loved UB40?
She would get all
She'd be sitting there. She'd be working. She'd be like, red, red wine, mowing your lawn.
G-Lo, yeah. Hell yeah. It kept her rocking all of the time.
All right, so that part of red, red wine where all of a sudden they have a token not white, I assume Scottish person, show up. Where it's like, yeah. We're like, red, red, white, reggae.
Like, he does, like the duddy rock reggae.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like half rap.
Okay, that dude sounds to me like our Captain Morgan.
Warm, right? What are you talking
about? Exactly. All right, so I want to simulate it. All right, UB40. So okay. I'm going to sing.
I'm here for you, Brian.
I'm going to sing UB40 off key and I'm going to toss it to you. Ready? Red, red wine. You make me feel I don't remember the words.
Red, red wine. Make me feel so fine. I'm the captain all of the time. I was part-time and then I got a raise. And then I celebrated it for days. I got on a pontoon and I peed off it. And then I said, that's a fancy-ass dick. I looked at my dick and I gave it some coats. That was coats, plural, because it was really cold. I had a cold dick and that was very warm, so I used it as a stove and I cooked some corn. I invented popcorn on my dick, and then I gave it to the Indians. Shit, they took all the credit, and now I'm a dick. I'm the fucking guy with just a piping hot stick between my legs, and then I made eggs on them, and I feel better for days.
Red, red wine! 1990s, name a band, go.
Nirvana.
That's a big one. What bigger?
Soundgarden.
Okay, they're also significant. One more. What do you got?
Norman Schwarzkopf.
Yes, his Stormin' Norman album was amazing. No, listen. If you were white and it was the 1990s, then you heard UB40.
Oh, dude.
With their,
yeah, they were huge.
Sure, because they ripped off all the greatest hits for the 60s, 70s, and 80s and repackaged them for the 90s. But have you heard, you know the song Red, Red Wine?
Who doesn't? It keeps me rocking all of the time.
Yes. Well, and so that part where someone who's not, I don't know who it is, they hired like a random hobo to go like, Red, Red Wine, you make me feel so fine and all that stuff.
Yeah.
I heard that and it made me think of our Captain Morgan.
Oh, I did know there, Brian.
Like in my mind, they hired.
Oh, the captain.
They hired. They hired Captain Morgan, and they're like, listen, just...
No, I was originally on the track, Brian.
All right, Captain, it's good to have you here. Listen,
I wanted to tell you what the original version was.
Okay, well, good. Well, then we're going to simulate it, because I'll sing off key before they auto-tune me, and I'll point to you. Here we go. Red, red wine, you make me feel so fine.
Red, red, white, you make me feel so fine. I am a captain and I sit, spit mad rhymes. I used to spit rhymes up on my boat and then I got a spaceship and I flew off. And then I was in space and I flew by planets. And then I met some bitch named Janet. Janet was a time traveler from the future. She said, Captain, you have a dire desire. I said, yeah, I do, to bang you in the butt. And then she would need to go into a different place. So we went back in time and we met this guy. His name was Abe Lincoln and he was pretty fly. He did four dances and one of them was the running man. But I said, dude, I was just doing the running man earlier. And the layers got fucked up that you did it and took credit. And he said, it's all right. And then he freed the slaves and now we're totally cool. And then I went and took his kids to school. His kid was a monster. He didn't know. It's because Mary Todd Lincoln fucked a hobo. The hobo was a Frankenstein monster, not Frankenstein the creator, because we will get weird about that.
Red, red, white. Oh my God.
All right. Dude, do you remember the 90s?
I love the 90s.
That's the next series I love on VH1. Do you remember a band from the 90s?
Yeah, no, I remember Nirvana.
They were significant. Name another.
How about Stone Temple Pilots?
Yes, they were also significant, but not as relevant as UB40.
Oh, God.
Because,
God damn,
because you and I are white, and that's why we know UB40.
Oh, man, whites went crazy for him.
Man, I'll tell you what, like UB40 was like white Nirvana. Too advanced. That was
we started shit. Going in a, yeah, I didn't.
Dude, were you alive in the 90s?
I was. Of them.
Do you remember a band and not Bobby Brown?
Oh, okay. No, not Bobby Brown. Then yeah, I remember Mariah Carey.
All right, keep going.
Nirvana.
Yep. And
the Ken Starr and his famous report.
Okay, look, you can't keep dancing around our friends at UB40.
Oh God, UB40, man, they were gigantic. Everybody loved UB40. Everybody was like, UB40's the best.
Yeah, they're all like our parents used to like those songs, but now UB40 made them cool.
Yeah, and they're British, and they kind of sound black. Isn't that weird?
But you see, not as black as the one guy who like pops in with like the rap solo in the middle of Red Red Wine,
the Duddy Rock, yeah, like, roots red, reggae, red wine, like credibility verse.
So fine, you saw all of the time. See, I hear that, and all I hear is our Captain Morgan.
Well, you do know, Brian.
See, okay, this is exactly what I want to do. Can we hear if Captain Morgan was the original rhymer on that?
That may have you, Brian.
All right, listen, I'm gonna lead you in, I'll point, and we'll go. Ready? Red, okay. Red wine.
Red, red wine, you make me feel so fine. I grew wings and I flew in time. It took me a while to learn how to fly, but I learned because I was on Wikipedia. Wikipedia was vetted when I was around, but that doesn't mean that I can't dance like Bobby Brown. Bobby Brown was a friend of mine, and one time he smoked crack. I didn't call the cops because I'm not a snitch like that. The captain don't snitch, and he ain't no bitch. That's how you know that the captain is rich. I'm rich like Scrooge McDuck, and that means I don't give a fuck, and I have feathers.
Red, red wine.
The 90s. What do you remember? Go.
I remember Y2K.
Yeah, that was okay. And
toward the end, right? Everybody freaking out about it. Wait, I remember.
All right, start. The 90s. What do you remember?
I remember Nirvana.
Yeah, they were significant. And
Norman Schwarzkopf.
And
Jorts.
Okay, none of those were UB40.
No, they weren't.
None of those were white enough answers, and I include Nirvana in not white enough answers.
You include Jorts?
UB40 was the whitest thing on planet Earth, where it's like, let's take everything your parents loved from the 60s and make it lovable in the 90s, especially that Red Red Wine song. You remember that?
Yeah, it was huge. Yeah.
Okay, so that part where they get somebody who sounds like they might conceivably not be white.
Yeah, that's like the credibility verse where it's like, oh no, we're an actual reggae band.
Right, red, red, why you make me feel so? Tell me that guy doesn't sound like our Captain Morgan.
Yeah, drinking wine. Ryan, why you already have a captain on your mind? Oh,
yeah. See, this is my fantasy. I want to lead in and hear if Captain was. I want to hear the Captain. Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, well, let's get the original verse. Ready? Red, red wine.
Red, red wine, you make me feel so fine. I built a house out of a giant lime. It was like that buster-ass piece of shit, James, except I filled mine with a bunch of dames. Not a giant peach like a beach. I fucking built it out of limes because I'm like a sneech with a star on my belly, not upon thars, because I'm the man and you drive cars that are tiny that you fit clouds in. You are a clown yourself, which is why I mentioned the size of your car. Your car's a weird piece of shit and you won't drive far because it drives gas that was made of Shars. And by Shars, I mean Charlene's, because I'm using a shortened version of their name. And you, I fucking hate you. Shut up. I'm the captain.
Let's start a new
one. I don't know how much more.
Come on. You never know. You might just hit it. Let's just freestyle. The 90s. You remember anything?
Yeah, I remember the Cranberries.
The Cranberries and Nirvana and Stone Temple Pilots. And what you've not mentioned is UB40.
No. Oh, God. Yeah, no,
because you're
gigantic.
Not white enough to remember UB40.
Nope. Actually, no, true fact, that was actually like the third album I bought was a UB40
album. Okay,
fine.
You are white enough. Congratulations. Here's your prize. But you're not as white as the guy who pretended to be black, being like the red, red, why do you make me feel so fried?
Wasn't black?
I don't know. I'm making this up. Look, go with it. All I know is that the moment that bit comes on in Red, Red Wine, all I hear is the captain. Captain Morgan.
Captain Morgan?
Yes. All right. Oh, indulge. Indulge me here.
Well, captain on the
captain
top of your dome.
It's the early 90s and we got a track for you. Listen, I'm gonna toss to you. Here we go. Red, red wine, you make me feel so fine.
Red, red wine, you make me feel so fine. I filled a bucket with my own pea brine. My brine was green because I drink Gatorade, and you're a piece of shit because you are a slave. I don't mean that in an offensive way. I mean it in a way that is like historical white slavery. Not to say that that shit is cool, but one time I was a slaver, and I wasn't a fool. It was a weird phase that I went through, and I regret it through and through, and that's on me. We all have a crosses to bear in life, and the captain's is that he was once a slaver.
It's not where I thought. It's not where I thought. The good news is we'll now have a track, a bonus track for the patrons.
All right, just say, know what I heard on the
Know what I heard on the radio?
What'd you hear on the radio?
Wow, you didn't offer any guesses or nothing. Fuck
Pat
you.
Benatar.
I listened to the radio. Remember that?
Pat Benatar.
I was listening to the radio. Remember that?
Sorry.
I was listening to the radio. You remember that?
Yeah, I love the radio.
Yeah, what do you think I was listening to?
I think you were listening to the Monkees.
No.
You were listening to Pat Benatar.
No.
You were listening to the Proclaimers.
No.
Who were you listening to?
Keep going.
You were listening to FDR's Fireside Chats. You were listening to All Things Considered, but like old episodes, because you tape them and then you play them back. Although it's not the radio, but you call it the radio like you're an 80-year-old person.
I was listening to the radio. Guess what I was listening to?
Pat Benatar.
Nope.
The Cranberries.
Nope, but you were close. 1990s. It was UB40.
Wait, all right. Which song?
Which do you think? Take a guess.
I mean, probably the biggest was Red, Red Wine.
Yeah, you make me feel so fine, some, all of the time. Every time I hear that rap part, it sounds like Captain Morgan to me.
Hi.
So, which makes me believe they kidnapped him and they brought him into the studio. This is just one of many adventures that he had. So it's like, Captain, listen, we're a bunch of, like, I assume white British dudes trying to do reggae, but we need to toss to someone for, like, reggae clout.
I'm of the islands.
Okay, good. Listen, I'm going to point at you, and then when it's go time, ready? Red, red wine.
Red, red wine, you make me feel so fine. I drank a bottle of Bud Light Lime. It's weird that I said that in the 90s, because it's about 15 years before the product comes out. Speaking of out, your mom is gay. Also, I got a big payday for rapping on this track because I'm cool, and that means that you're a fool. If you spell fool backwards, then it's loof. That's what my first mate's name was. He was uncouth. He used to say things like, I hate Jews.
It was so cool.
I was like, Loof, that ain't cool.
All right, so I listened to the radio. Remember that? And guess what I heard?
Oh, a song.
Yes, but by whom?
By Ace Frehley.
No, keep going.
Was it...
It was UB40. Do you remember them?
I was about to say that.
All right, so UB40, like, their number one hit is that Red Red Wine song, right?
Oh, sure, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, okay, but that part where they get, like, the token non-white British person to
be like, yeah, that's, like, their, like, credibility verse, yeah, where they're like, we're really a reggae band.
You have your red, red wine, you make me feel so fine,
It's like, to me, it sounds like our Captain Morgan the entire time.
Oh,
which red, red wine, you make me sail with limes. See, I can't even do it, but I bet the captain can. Captain, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here for you, Brian.
All right, Captain, listen, I'm going to sing the intro. I'm going to point at you. We're going to lay this track down and we'll be famous. You ready?
Okay.
All right. Red, red wine.
Red, red wine, you make me feel so fine. My name's Captain Morgan. Say no to crime. I'm just kidding. Fucking break all the laws. I'm a badass. And then I grew paws. It was because I fucked a werewolf. And then one day I got fucking wolf powers because it was the moon and it came out full. And I was like, fool, that's really cool. I turned into a wolf and I sailed the seas in a wolf boat that I called Bitches on Your Knees. It was because I actually just came up with it. It was from a Norse fable, but then it turned out Bitches blew me on the label. The label of the boat is what I kept in the front. And then I put my dick in the butt. That was my calling card. That's how they knew that I was aboard. They said, did somebody have a dick in their butt? And then they said, yeah, well, the captain must be a foot. And I said, a foot? That means that I'm going to put my foot down on your boat because it's the pound. I keep dogs there.
Red, red wine. You make me feel so fine.